What's up, guys? Pools here, back with another video. Today we have a SWAT RFT best sorrowful classed up for hardcore in Black Ops 4. No doubt, one of my favorites to use. This gun overall just absolutely slaps in hardcore. They have some running a reflex sight, long barrel cinemags, FMJ, ComSec device. The perks I'm running are dexterity and gung-ho, a perfect combo for hardcore, and I'll get into, you know, everything about the class setup, all of that and stuff like that. Before I get into that, man, I want you guys to all hit that like button, hit that notification bell, that subscribe, and let's get to 20 likes on this video. I know we can do that, man. I know you guys are allowed. I know you guys are able to hit that like button, because I do it every single video I watch, so I know you guys can do the same. Let's make sure that happened, man. Before I get, I'm going to cover the class of everything about it, and then I'll talk about something about with my channel, what my ideas are for Black Ops 4, why my channel's been really delayed on content, really slow on content the past couple weeks. I'll get all that, but first, let's cover the class of the video, man. Reflex sight, obviously to see better, man. The sights on this gun are absolute garbage. Long barrel, with long barrel on this gun, it is most, I think, I'm pretty sure it's one shot, one kill at any single range in this whole game. With long barrel, which is pretty insane. FMJ, obviously, just to be able to hit through the body armor. I hate getting hit markers in hardcore. I hate having to, like, you know, you're shooting through like a pack of people, like 3 or 4 people, and like the fourth person has body armor on and he kills you because you didn't one shot him. And just the FMJ allows you to just one shot the body armor, and then through some maps and stuff, you can wallbang the walls, like firing range and stuff like that. You can wallbang. On Cinemax, obviously, I think it's like a 50 bullet clip or something crazy with the SWAT, so that's really, really nice to have in your play, especially when you're in hardcore, if you're spawn trapping, whatever you're doing, it's very, very nice to have that 50 bullet clip. It benefits you a lot, and you can get a lot easier kills and stuff. The pros and cons of the gun. The pros, the gun slaps at every single range. That's why I like it. It has unlimited range. It's good up close. It has great fire rate for up close encounters. As decent, it was just overall just a very, very good gun at all ranges. Overall, a smacking of a weapon for hardcore. Another pro is obviously has a lot, a big bullet count. And it has some very good attachment options. If you want to, you can throw a suppressor on it. You can, you know, you can throw a quick draw on it. You can throw stock on it. There's a lot of attachment options you can use for this gun. So if you find my class setup not working out for you, put on your own class setup, because I guarantee you that'll work better than anything. If you guys can find your own class that you enjoy, you know, you'll love it. Anyways, the negatives about the gun is it does have a lot of recoil. Sometimes you find yourself missing a few bullets at range and stuff if you just hold on the R2 button or your shoot button. Sometimes you gotta tap fire and you gotta kind of be more accurate, especially on, as you can see on maps like this where I'm, you know, tap firing instead of just holding down the R2 button. It allows me to kill them faster, be more accurate with my shots. And thirdly is the aim down sight is really, really slow. It's not really, really slow, but it's definitely a huge downside without quick draw, but I honestly have just gotten used to it, just pre-aiming everything. The ADS does kind of get you killed sometimes, and yeah, overall this gun is my favorite sorrowful in hardcore. You know, it definitely surpasses every single other gun, because, you know, this gun's insane. The fire rate with the unlimited range pretty much all just makes for a really, 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 really good gun. I absolutely love it. So if you guys, highly, highly recommend this for you guys to use in hardcore. Now, before I end the video, man, I really want to talk to you guys about a more kind of like a more serious topic on the channel. If you guys made this far in the video, I want you guys to comment hashtag SWATRF or SWATRFT in the comment section. It'd be greatly appreciated. What I want to talk about today is why Black Ops 4, why my channel, why I haven't been uploading, why I haven't been streaming, and all this type of stuff. Is just going to kind of clear some things up for you guys. Hopefully, it'll keep you guys, you know, occupied until I find motivation for this game again. First off, I want to say is Black Ops 4 is so dry, and the content on it is so dry. If I were to upload daily, only thing I could upload would be, you know, classic videos and tips and tricks videos and stuff. That's what my channel is based on. That's what I've always found success on the channel. But still, it absolutely sucks. That's your only limit to the content. There's no new guns coming out. There's no, you know, there's no new cool camos. There's no like new score streaks. Nothing cool where I can make content on and get like a large amount of views. I can just average, you know, that 100, 200 views, and that's really, you know, it's sufficient for me. I like it. For somehow I'm still growing. Somehow I'm still gaining subscribers. When I uploaded like twice last week, I still gained like 15 or 20 subs last week. I have no idea how. I have not been putting my effort into it. But I do appreciate you guys sticking, the people that are sticking by, the people that are watching my content almost 24/7. I do still appreciate it. The ones that come out to my videos every single day, it does mean so much. For the future, man, I'm gonna try to upload more. I really do feel guilty about not getting content to you guys. I feel that, you know, thoughts of quitting have come into my mind. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not really the most motivated person at the moment to do YouTube. I have so many other things going on in my life. You know, I just started doing more social things, you know, getting out of that. I was just enjoying my life more, honestly. Black Ops 4 is just not where I want to spend my time. My sports, you know, talking to a girl, you know, with friends, school, everything combined. It's so hard to make time for that, you know, that hour or 2 hours in my day and that hour after school to make that video or to pop up a stream or something. But I will do my best to keep it up and to keep the content rolling for you guys as much as possible, as long as possible. Until I believe the new operation is dropping very soon, so hopefully I'll make some content on that, get some more videos out, maybe feel more motivated then. But that's it for the video, man. Appreciate you guys showing love, coming by. If you guys made this far in the video, I will have a link in the description to you know, watch my Twitch. I'm gonna be streaming The Division 2 over on Twitch. If you guys want to check that out, I don't know, it's up to you. That's it for now, man. Appreciate you guys stopping by. You guys are all legends. Make sure you hit that subscribe and that notification bell, that like button. If you guys made this far in the video, make sure to comment hashtag SWAT. You already know, you know what's up with that. I'll do my best to get the content for you guys, man. I really, really do feel bad, and I'm going to try my best from here on out. Peace out, everyone, man, and I'll see you guys in the next video or stream, whenever that happens to be. Peace.
I got aimbot. So you smucked him? The fuck does that mean? Bot can. Mobamba. I'ma kill you, Mobamba. Come back, kid. Get out of here. This is my spawn trap. Come on, kid. Who is this in the back spawn? Fuck off. Fuck off. This is my spawn trap.